Research methodology is designed for an MBA second semester student, but as a subject, it is one of the important subjects, no doubt. But it is not only important because it is designed for an MBA student. It is also important for a PhD student who are enrolled themselves to research program. And in a today's scenario, this is one of the important aspects through which the various company, the various organization, firms, education industry, any industry in the market, they all are conducting research to find something new or creative as well as some innovative techniques, right? Before starting that research methodology, I'm going to define it, what is exactly the research as well as methodology. To understand research methodology, first you have to knowledge about what is meaning of research. First, research is a combination of two words. One is research, re plus search, right? Here, re means repetition of any event, means doing each and every event again and again. And search means that getting something new, right? It means research is a one of the art through which, or you can say a scientific or systematic process through which a new information can be get, right? Now, research is basically scientifically investigation to get a something new which is useful for your purpose, right? In another words, Redman and Mori define research as a systematic efforts to gain new knowledge, right? It means there is a systematic way, step by procedure through which you can get something new which is not till the end of date you can find in the market. This is one kind of obtaining the knowledge which is not known for today's scenario, right? Now, research is an academic activity through which is used in a technical sense, and it is basically a combination of various activity. In words of Clifford Woody, the research compiles, first you have to define or identify the problems. If you are identifying the problems, what you are facing or the society is facing, you have to formulate a hypothesis or suggest a solution, right? Regarding to formulate hypothesis, you have to just collect, organize and evaluate the data, and after evaluation of data you are making some conclusion, and this is overall the research, right? It means research can be original contribution to existing stock of knowledge, right? Making for its advancement, fine. Now, what is basically research? Research can be, in a single word, can be defined as that systematic and scientific process through getting something new insight. Accordingly, you set goal or a purpose, right? In another word, research can be defined, or you can say it is a whole of the process which include the problem identification, the formulating of hypothesis, collecting the information or the data. After collection of data, you have to analyze the facts, right? And after analyzing the facts, you can come the conclusion through take. You can take a decision or a solution for that problem. Now, in our next part of this, what is objective of research? Right here, this is what objective of research. What is your scope, or you can say what is application of a scientific purpose? Why you are going to conduct any research? You have to decide exactly what is aim of research. Whether you just find out the truth only, there is something hidden to that research, or there is some special purpose by which you are getting something new knowledge, right? There are four points through which you can understand what is exactly the objective of the research. The first part in this is what? To gain familiarity with a phenomena. Or you can say in another words that to achieve new insight into it. It means this kind of a research is known as an exploratory or formulative research study. It means you have to only familiar the characteristics which is related to a particular incident or an event. You just want to achieve the main features of the particular information, right? It is known as a exploratory or a formulative research, right? In a second one research, to portray accurately the characteristics of a particular individual, situations, or a group. It means it is a kind of a descriptive research. It means you have to just analyze all the characteristics which is associated to a particular research or a data or any event. You just go through the all the features which is associated to particular individual. Study about the each and every features, right? This is known as descriptive research. If we are going to study to determine the frequency with which something occurs or with which it is associated with something else, it is known as a diagnostic research. Generally, the diagnostic research is conducted in laboratory because we just want to know that event, how many times that event would be conducted to get something new, right? In a last, the last objective of research is what? To test a hypothesis. Basically, the hypothesis is what? The causal relationship between the two variables. It may be the relationship would be positive or a negative, or sometime it is not related, right? So to know about whether the variables are related or not related, fine, then this is known as a to test a hypothesis. Basically, what is motivation to get something new? What is objective, or you can say what is role of research in today's era? That is one of the important part, because for this you have to just solve there something motive behind to conduct any of the research. The first part in this is desire to get research degree along with its consequential benefits. If we are talking about it today era, like lockdown situation in India, here there is a very much a challenge to solve very unsolved problem. It may be that is related to a various sector of the India, right? We are suffering a challenge to solve the problem, which is very much in an indirect way or a hidden way. We are going to conduct something new to achieve our objective. And due to this reason, we have to use a various digital mode to solve the problem, because we are locked in a one roof and we want to just give some productive worth to the economy by digitalize our work in today's situation, right? So there is some motive. First, desire to get a research degree along with its consequential benefits, desire to face the challenges in solving the unsolved problem, right? Also, to get something intellectual joy of doing some creative or innovative work. Here we get something new, what we didn't get previously. Because there is no as such requirement of solving the problem through this way, right? But here we can get something which is very much creative or innovative. It means research can arise something very innovative situation also. Next in this is desire to be of service to society and also to get some respect and aspect to getting something new for the society, right? It means there is various factor through which any people can be motivated and conduct research study. Sometime by the government order or direction of government or employment condition, the various research program would be conducted to the society to know about whether employability ratio or a birth rate, death rate, various other research program would be also conducted for awareness of the society, right? This is one of the aspects through which any people can be motivated to conduct a research program, right? After that, I'm going to explain you the types of research, right? This is one of the important topic in the research methodology. What is basic types of research? The first part in this is the descriptive versus analytical, right? What is exactly the descriptive research? In a descriptive research, the various surveys and fact and finding inquiries of a different kinds can be conducted. The major purpose, or you can say the motive behind to descriptive research, is description to detail out of the state of affairs as it exists at a present. What are the various descriptive features of the existing event? Fine. It is basically conducted in a social science and a business research. Fine. In another term, it is also conducted the ex post facto research for a descriptive research study. The main characteristics of this method is there is no control over the variables. Researcher has no control over the variable. If you are going to conduct any research, fine. First, you have to acknowledge what has happened and what is happening. Fine. And you don't have a control over the variables which exist in a research. Most ex post facto research projects are used for a descriptive research, in which the researcher seeks to measure such items, for example, frequency of a shopping, preferences of people, or a similar data. In another word, you can say that if I want to know about for a particular mall that how many persons are coming to this mall to purchase a particular shoes, a branded shoes, for example, Nike. I don't have a control over the participant who are coming to mall for the purpose of some purchasing of new goods or a shoes. I don't control over them, right? I have to conduct the research program on them by counting themselves and by asking some of the questionnaire which is related to this research program, right? Next in this is The methods of research utilized in descriptive research are survey method basically of all kind, including comparative, correlation. These all are the methods through which we can conduct the descriptive research. Fine. What is exactly the analytical research? Analytical research has to use to get the information which is already available in the market. It means if the research program for getting that information is already available, only you have to analyze the these event and you have to just make a critical evaluation on that material. Right? So there is a lots of difference between descriptive and analytical. In analytical, you are going to conduct only the analysis which have already existed. The information is already existed in the market, right? But in a descriptive, you have to conduct a survey program either using by comparative or correlation method, right? In a next, applied and fundamental. In applied versus fundamental, researcher can either be applied research or a fundamental research. What is difference between applied and a fundamental research? Applied research aims at finding a solution for an immediate problem facing by a society or an industry, right? It means the immediate solution of the problem which is existing in a today scenario, right? But fundamental research mainly concerned with the generalization, which is very much a pure or which is based on some theory, right? It means gathering knowledge for a knowledge sake is a termed as a pure or a fundamental research. Whereas applied research, immediate solution of the problem which exists in the society, right? In this, research to identify the social or economical or political trends that may affect a particular institution or to compare research or the marketing research are the example of the applied research, right? Means there are some trends, social trend, economical trend or a political trend that affect on a particular institution, particular industry, right? These are the example of applied research. When researchers are the part of that event or a research, then it is known as a action research. Right? Get it my point? It means if the researcher is a part of that research program, then it is considered as a action research. And fundamental research is a very pure in a nature as well as generalized, right? Next is, what is quantitative or a qualitative research? Quantitative research is based on the measurement of a quantity or amount. It is applicable to phenomena that can be expressed in a term of only quantity, whereas qualitative research is a qualitative in nature. It means the phenomena relating to or involving quality or a kind. It is basically conduct for the human behavior to get information about the human behavior. So qualitative research or a motivational research is basically used to know the behavior of the human, the psychology of the human behavior, right? For this, they are going to conduct a various techniques to conduct in various techniques to get the information of the behavior of the human. For this, they are going to conduct association test, sentence completion test, story completion test, and similar other projective techniques. Right. To know about the attitude or opinion research, research design is to find how many people or what they think about the particular subject or a matter. Right? Qualitative research is especially important in a behavioral science. In another way, quantitative research only based on a quantity of the research. Right? Now, in a last, conceptual versus empirical. It is also important research design. Conceptual research is that which is related to a abstract ideas or a theory. You can say it is generally used by a philosopher or thinker to develop some new concept or to reinterpret existing one, which is already present in the market, and you can evaluate it and develop on the basis of that ideas. You can develop their own strategy or a own concept, right? On the other hand, empirical research relies on experiences or observation alone. It is data-based research coming up with conclusion which is based on some experimental or observation based, right? It means there is some kind of experiment which is designed to solve the empirical research, and generally it is based on some formula. Fine. It means you have to conduct some experiment and you have to observe it, and here you can manipulate or you can some control over the variables, right, which is used in a experiment. You can control over it, right. This is what the empirical, and where you have to just develop some concept on existing one theory. This is known as conceptual, right? Now, the next in this is, what are the other miscellaneous types of research? We are just going through point wise some other research. All other type of research in which one-time research or a longitudinal research. One-time research, you have to conduct only a single time research to get knowledge, new information. But in a longitudinal research, you are going to conduct research program for a same event to again and again, or a several time, right? Next one is a field setting research or a laboratory research, or you can say a simultaneous research. Field setting, the research program is conducted on a field survey, or in a laboratory research, you have to conduct a research program in a labs only. And in a simultaneous research, when you are going to conduct any research program in a real life situation, this is known as a simultaneous research, right? Now, the next one is a clinical or diagnostic. When you are going to conduct any research program on a clinic, or you can conduct a program to diagnose something which is very new, right? This is the difference between clinical or diagnostic research, or you can say in-depth research. Fine. Now, what is historical research? Historical research is based on some documents, right? For example, like historical research, you can say building of or a preparation to make a temple on Ayodhya. This is based on a historical research, because various documents related to that are collected to prove it, whether there is a birth of that Lord Rama or not, right? Now, these are basically the whole of the type of research. I hope that you all people are benefited by this video, because this is one of the whole and soul conclusion about the what is exactly the research, the objective of research, what are the motive behind to take any research program, as well as in types of research. In our next part of this video, I'm going to tell you about the other research importance, process, as well as the difference between the various research variables, right? And also to get information or a briefing about the research methodology. Thank you so much for watching my video.